hazardous materials, they might upset some people, so discretion is advised. It is a hunting video.
Kia ora and good day. My name is Tony, and this is Ross, my business partner, your professional guide for hunting and trout fishing.
We're about to go on a little hunt, so if you'd like to join us, we'd be happy to have you along and see what we can see and what we can shoot.
All right.
Sweet as.
Well, one of the important jobs in New Caledonia when we hunt for Rusa is somebody to provide meat for the camp. And usually we take young hinds or spikers for that. And we always send a camera and a couple of guys to go and try to get meat for hunters. So I've added a couple of hunts in this video.
If it stops. Take him.
Oh, mate, which one did you shoot? I missed it completely, mate. I missed it. Never mind. What did you hit?
I'm not quite sure, mate. I was aiming for a headshot, and she's definitely dead, and she rolled straight over. I have no idea. The blood is there from your knife mark, but she went over like she'd been headshot and didn't go anywhere.
I reckon you scared the shit out of him, mate.
It doesn't matter. Forget it.
Huh?
It doesn't matter.
You rolling, Murray? Good.
I should.
Yeah, whenever you like.
Can you hear her? She's going, she's in front, she's leaving, she's going too fast, and oh yeah, I think she's hit. She went over the ridge. We gotta go and check. You rolling, Murray?
Oh yeah.
Right, we just came up the ridge, and there it is. She's lying there. She ran about a couple of 300 meters. I think she's hit in the chest. Here we go. A very big part of hunting Rusa in New Caledonia, or even in New Zealand for that matter, is glassing and trying to see them first in ridges, corners, valleys, and saddles, and so on and so forth. And when you find them, you have to try to assess their trophies before you even start stalking and get close to the range that you can take them. It is notoriously hard to stalk Rusa deer in the bush. They are very alert, always on tiptoes and ready to bark and disappear. If you are alone, you may have a chance. And if you are with somebody else or you try to film, the chances are very, very small.
Let's see.
where we saw this stag about a kilometer away, and we came over a big ridge, and we are about 400 to 500 meters away. He looks pretty good. Most probably we're gonna take him. About 20 minutes later, we saw him quite low in the valley. He had moved about a few hundred meters from the top of the ridge into the valley.
I think this one is better, huh?
He's good. Shall we take him?
Ready.
Come on.
Go ahead.
Rico. Rico. Yeah, get the rangefinder, mate. See how far it is. It can't be over 400. Yeah. Rico, you shoot him. Hey, me? Somebody has to film. Okay.
He's looking at us. Don't move too much.
I can't hit him in the neck, mate.
340.
Piece of piece, yeah, no problem.
How do you bring it closer?
Ready.
Okay, Ari?
Yes.
Okay, wait. Ari, you alright?
Yes.
Hit him a little bit in the back, but never mind. I don't think he's gonna go too far. He was badly hit.
That's 6.5, I reckon.
The entry, it went in and destroyed the spine. It ran only about 20-25 meters and collapsed right here.
There we go. Last bit.
Hope you enjoyed this hunt.
We hope to see you in New Zealand sometime.
Kaki te anō.
And he says we'll see you later.
All right. Keep well. Look after yourself and your mates when you hunt. Be prepared. And I'll be seeing you next time.